Hi dear cricket fans, subscribers and friends, welcome to a very, very latest update from the Ashes Test Series between England and Australia. And well, it has been wrapped up quickly, just in 50 minutes. In fact, Australia have actually leveled the Ashes Series 1-1. And well, I'm just coming in because just the match has just finished and England are all out for 123. It was quickly wrapped up. It was a show, a Ryan Harris show actually. Ryan Harris got his first 5-wicket haul today. And he has figures of 11 overs, 1 made and 47 runs and 6 wickets. And the 5-match series is now level at 1-1. It was so easily done. As I said, it took only 15 minutes. There was absolutely no resistance. Just to recap what exactly happened here at the Wacha in Perth on the fourth day. The match is all done and dusted. In fact, everything was over pretty quickly. It all started with the first wicket to go today was Anderson, the night watchman, who couldn't. He got his off stump bent back when Harris actually went through his defenses as he was caught on the back foot. So that was the first wicket to go. After that, Pryor just hit 1-6, which actually top edged over the keeper's head of Harris, and it went for a 6. After that, the next over from Harris, he in fact picked up 2 wickets in one over. First was Bell actually, who played across the line, and well, that's it. It was probably going into the stump, so he was at just LBW board. Harris for 16 with 3 fours, and Pryor also couldn't do much. He was gone. A beautiful catch taken by Mike Hussey. Actually, it was a short of length. It had a bit of bounce. Actually, he tried for a forward prod. And it took actually the shoulder of the bat, and the gully, Hussey was the one who actually paused the catch of the bowling of Harris for 10. Swan hit a 4 and that was it. In fact, Johnson got his third wicket there, and Swan had actually played on to Johnson. Johnson actually had him clean bowled for 9. And well, after that everything was finished. Stephen Finn actually was taken very nicely by Smith at third slip of the bowling of Harris. As I said, Harris was the man who did all the damage there. In 15 minutes, the match was all over. Australia have actually leveled the series 1-1 right now. In fact, England were all out for 123, resuming at 81 for 5. And Australia won this match by a very, very big margin of 267 runs. Now, dear cricket fans, what is really is going to be very interesting is the Ashes series is really hotting up right now. And just seeing at the, since I have some time here, looking at the positives which has come, one is Mitchell Johnson, who has run into some good form. He was dropped in the previous match, but he has come back very, very strongly. In fact, he contributed with the bat, he contributed with the ball, and that is something very, very heartening for Australia for sure, because he had a 6-wicket scalp in the first, 3-wicket scalp in the second innings. Ryan Harris got 6. Michael Hussey, always the man in form. But what is very good is Australia finally are breathing again, because Australia, as you know, they are finding it very, very difficult, in fact, to just get on with things here. And finally now Australia have started firing. So that is something the Australian fans should be very, very happy about. The other thing that I can really talk about is probably Michael Clarke needs to get into some form. Ponting has become a big, big question mark, and Ponting is the one who has to really, I hope this motivates Ponting, and Ponting suddenly starts getting runs and he starts flowering. It's very, very important for Australia that that happens. That's very important. Phil Hughes got his chance here and he has muffed it, but probably now, if Cattage is not going to be fed, Phil Hughes can get one more chance. So that is something. England are the ones who have to really do they have to really search like where exactly they went wrong and what exactly needs to be done. They definitely have a good blend. It was a big surprise that England actually folded up in such a manner. Absolute credit for the Australian bowlers for the way they bowled, especially as I said, Mitchell Johnson, who really started it all by actually, even though Australia were dismissed for 268, he actually rolled them out it was a 6 for 38 effort that did England in. And after that, it was just easy meat for Australia. In fact, they got a good score on the board and set up 390. It was always going to be difficult, as I said in my last preview. And finally, everything's over. So the five-match series is level 1-1. The Ashes series is really hotting up right now. And it's very good to see that suddenly there is some sort of life in the Ashes now. Because Australia have done something which they're going to be really, really proud about, because I know things have become very rare for Australia nowadays as far as victories are concerned. So this is something which is going to be really, really hearten them. Well, dear cricket fans, I don't have much time to share. It's almost 10:45 here in Canada. I'm going to wind up this report. I'll be back with the full match report tomorrow between India and South Africa on the fourth day, where India are actually backs to the wall right now, 294 runs required to make South Africa bat again. Again, that's also going to be a Herculean task, but with the Indian batting lineup, I can't discount that, with VVS Lakshman, Tendulkar, Dhoni, Raina, a plethora of batting to follow, Rahul Dravid at the crease. But again, it all depends how they negotiate the pace of Mon Markle and Dale Steyn. Probably the foot marks might help, where Paul Harris, the left-arm spinner, might play a good role. And always he has had a good time against India, Paul Harris. So let's hope we have a good game of cricket there at the Centurion Supersport Park. Probably it should be starting in 4.5 first time. That's it, dear cricket fans, subscribers and friends for Cricket Happenings. This is Ram signing off. Thank you.